Let's talk about the SPX3819 voltage regulator. If you are trying to build a power efficient battery based device, like a temperature sensor for example, then you will probably want to ditch the popular voltage regulators that you find in Arduinos or any devices that are usually plugged in all the time. Those tend to have characteristics that make them specially bad for battery-powered devices. The 7805 or the LM1117 are very popular, but have more than 1.2 dropout voltage, making them almost useless for LiPo or lithium-ion batteries, for example. Let's take a fully charged LiPo battery with 4.2 volts, then subtract the 1.2 or 1.6 dropout volt, then you get less than 2. Something volt out, which is, as you know, lower than the 3.3 required by most MCUs and sensors. This is where the low dropout voltage regulators shine. So if you are in that boat, you might want to consider an LDO like the SPX3819 by MaxLinear. This is not by no means the only LDO out there. In fact, there are plenty. Here are some to name a few. But what I really like about this specific LDO is its specs, size, cost, and features. I will get to that in a bit. As a matter of fact, I have used this LDO in multiple projects, including my ultra-low power trigger sensor. It allowed me to drop down a LiPo battery voltage to the 3.3 volt needed for the ESP8266 module, while keeping up with the peak current required. The SPX3819 can provide up to 500 milliamps. So aside from its power regulation capabilities, it also has an enable pin. This enable feature allows a signal to shut down or power up the LDO itself, thus turning the power on and off to whatever the LDO is powering. This is very handy to have with power hungry devices that you might want to keep off while not in use. For example, in my ultra-low sensor, I used an itty tiny microcontroller to monitor an input switch while keeping the ESP8266 microcontroller off. Then I used the enable pin to power the ESP8266 on only when I need to send an update over Wi-Fi, keeping the ESP8266 off the majority of the time and lowering the energy consumptions of the whole sensor. Other features of the LDO that I find very useful are the reverse battery protection, so no more magic smoke when plugging in the battery the wrong way. Also, the zero off mode current. When it's off, there are no leak currents, which is excellent for batteries. There is also the overcurrent protection. It shuts off above the 500 milliamps limit, handy if accidentally the positive and negative power rails are shorted. There is also a thermal shutdown, and it also supports up to 500 milliamps load, which is plenty of juice for the ESP8266 peaks. It also accepts input voltage up to 16 volts, not that I ever needed that, but it opens the possibility of using 12 volts battery if I really needed to. And last but not least, it's very cheap, somewhere from 20 to 60 cents, depending on the quantity. You can even get 20 of them for a buck or two from China. This LDO comes in two versions. The first is a fixed output voltage for the popular 3.3, 5 volts and others. And the second, it comes with the adjustable output voltage version, where the output voltage is controlled using resistors ratios. I have only used the fixed 3.3 voltage version, as the majority of my MCUs and sensors are 3.3. This LDO only comes in surface mount package, but you can always get an SMD to DIP adapter to use them while prototyping. So next time you find yourself looking for a nicely packaged LDO with enable and protection features, make sure to put the SPX3819 on your list. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Peace.